Hey everybody, it's Master Gallengeist here, bringing you my review of the latest episode of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., The Team. So, I really liked this episode. This was a really solid episode, because there were essentially two episodes in one. We got to see the Secret Warriors in action, and Daisy leading them and everything, and then at the back end, we kind of got the Thing kind of episode, trying to figure out what's going on and who can be trusted. It was really effective, though maybe a little bit fast in how it was executed, considering this is the back end of the season. So, in the beginning, Daisy was able to assemble her team of secret warriors to try and rescue the Zephyr and all of those captured agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. And it was really well executed, showing everyone's control of their powers and how effective they are at utilizing their powers in a team environment. Joey was able to melt bullets as they were coming at him, and Yo-Yo was able to just take people out. There was really good banter showing a good kind of cohesive team. Link was able to start doing stuff with his powers that I, quite frankly, didn't know that he could do, such as utilizing the electricity that he can use in kind of a whip-like fashion in his, like, combat moves, showing that he's growing from the doctor kind of person from Afterlife into more of a hardened agent of S.H.I.E.L.D. with his combat prowess. It was really cool and effective. And then, after they were able to do that and kind of actually capture Gideon Malik, which was surprising, and try and get everybody off, Joey was the one that took out the dude who's got the Medusa-like powers that can take people and pretty much paralyze them. And I was like, oh shit, he actually killed him. I'm like, that was really effective, and I wish there was more time devoted to like how that affected Joey. Well, they get back and some kind of weird stuff's going on, and that things are not acting quite as right at the base, and the dead body is like at an act like it has an actual body temperature that's above like what would usually be for a corpse. So it's like, what the hell's going on with this? And they start digging around in his head and find out that he's got a parasite in there that really doesn't do any harm but allows for mind control. And they're like, could one of our teammates be infected with that? One of the Inhumans. And it did a nice kind of cool homage to the Thing where they're like, who can be trusted? We just need to get everybody in quarantine. Coulson is actually, in my opinion, making the right call and trying to get all that set up. And they're like, listen, we just need everybody in quarantine, and the team's like, they turned on us because we're humans and blah, blah, blah. And it's like, then they start turning on each other. It was really cool and effective. And they did a lot of cool sleight of hands to show who could be the one that was infected. And it was really interesting to see Coulson pumping Malik for information because Malik is destroyed at this point since Hive has killed his daughter. He's leveling with Coulson. He's like, we made the wrong choice in bringing this thing back. It's not a god, it's the devil. And Coulson's just like, listen, Motive, I need you to help us. He's like, well, I didn't think my last rodeo would be like this. And then, of course, after all that, Malik's killed. I'm like, oh, I kind of wanted to see what he would do with S.H.I.E.L.D. It was an interesting, different territory. It was a nice evolution of his character. I just wish we could have seen more of it to come to more fruition, but his death was pretty effective in what it showed in how much control Hive has over his minions. At first, we thought it was kind of a cult aura kind of thing, but this goes way deeper than that. They still have agency, but Hive has a definite control on them. And it was really interesting that they chose Daisy to be the one that was infected because she manipulated everything perfectly to a T. I mean, using everyone's like characteristics against them, like Lincoln's anger and everything, and usually kind of bending rules and stuff to make Coulson suspect him. And it's just I like Daisy. I don't want anything really horrible to happen to her at this point because she's been growing and showing such good development. And I'm like, oh no, what's gonna happen? But it then's gonna put everybody else in an interesting position, and like Lincoln's gonna wanna do anything and everything he can to save her, and it'll be interesting to see how the other Inhumans on the team react to that. And It's going to be interesting to see, since she's got the orb now that Hive could use to possibly amplify his powers. I think that Shield's going to have to tap on Lash, because it seems like he's tailor-made to do this kind of dirty work to take out Hive. Because honestly, he is on a threat level as great as like Scarlet Witch, Thor at this point. This is like big shit that I don't know if Shield's capable of handling at this point. The only one who seems to be on like Hulk level, power level at this point is Lash, because they pretty much have to beat him into submission in order to put him into a containment module. So that's what I'm thinking. Now, when Daisy left the building and left their hideout, she pretty much was burying him alive, and I was like, oh crap. It's crazy because we finally got Simmons and Fitz. They're like, all right, we've been waiting 10 years. I'm like, yes, finally. We don't need this back and forth bull crap anymore. We got it. Yes. I also was like half expecting, all right, they're gonna put someone in there and it's gonna block everything again, and we're gonna go on around town. But I'm like, okay, good development. And it's just really interesting to see where this is gonna go next. I'm kind of excited to see how Daisy and Hive are going to interact, how that's going to be different, and how, if Daisy's aversion to war will affect Hive's sway at all. So those are my thoughts on the episode. Tell me what you guys think in the comments below. If you agree with me, if you disagree with me, if you liked it, if you didn't like it. Also, like and subscribe, and I hope you have a good day.